Hello students, in this first topic from second year program, we are going to learn about halogen derivatives of alkenes and arenes, that is halogen derivatives of saturated hydrocarbons and halogen derivative of aromatic compounds or aromatic hydrocarbons. Now, first of all, we'll learn what are haloalkanes and what are haloarenes. The replacement of one or more hydrogen atoms with corresponding number of halogen atoms from aliphatic or aromatic hydrocarbon results into formation of alkyl halides, which are also called as haloalkenes, or aryl halides, which are also called as haloarenes respectively. So when hydrogen from aliphatic hydrocarbon gets replaced, we end up with haloalkenes. And when hydrogen from aromatic hydrocarbon is replaced with halogen, we will end up with haloarenes. And when we are using the word haloalkane, that aliphatic hydrocarbon must be an alkane. Now, what are haloalkanes, which are indicated by Rx? Monohaloalkane will be indicated like Rx. Basically, X is attached to R, and R is nothing but sp3 hybridized carbon. R contains nothing but sp3 hybridized carbon. Whereas in haloarenes, that is ARXs, X is attached to aromatic nucleus. So basically X is attached to sp2 hybridized carbon. Now first we'll focus on halogen derivatives of alkanes. As the name suggests, halogen derivatives of alkanes are obtained from alkanes by replacing one or more hydrogen atoms with corresponding number of halogen atoms. They are called as halogen derivatives of alkanes or haloalkanes. Let's take example of first member of alkane series, that is methane. In methane, there are four hydrogens. One by one, we'll go on substituting the hydrogen atoms with halogen. When first hydrogen atom is replaced with halogen, we'll get a monohalogen derivative, which is methyl halide. When one more hydrogen is substituted, we are getting methylene dihalide. One more replaced with halogen, we are getting a chloroform. And when the last hydrogen is replaced with halogen, we are getting a tetrahalo derivative of methane. Now, depending upon the number of halogen atoms present in a molecule, that is how many hydrogen atoms from that particular compound are getting replaced with halogen, we can further classify the halogen derivatives of alkanes as follows. First category is monohalogen derivatives. When only one hydrogen atom of alkane is replaced with one halogen atom, we end up with monohalogen derivatives of alkanes. Monohalogen derivatives of alkanes are also called as alkyl halides. The general formula for alkanes is R. General formula for alkanes is RH. In monohalogen derivative, this H is substituted with X, right? So the formula for monohalogen derivative of alkane will be Rx. So that's why it is also called as alkyl halide. And it is indicated by the alkane is CN H2N plus 2. What change is happening? One hydrogen is getting reduced and one X is getting added. So what will be the overall formula for monohalogen derivative? CN H2N plus 1 X. These are the few examples. Methyl bromide. And this will be 1, 2, 3. 1-chloropropane. Next category is of dihalogen derivatives of alkanes. When two hydrogen atoms of alkanes are replaced with same or different halogen atoms, we'll get dihalogen derivatives. Dihalogen derivatives are represented by general formula CN. They are represented by the general formula CN H2N X2. That is CN H2N plus 2, this is the formula for alkane, minus 2 hydrogens and addition of 2 halogens. So overall formula will be CnH2n X2. They are further classified as geminal dihalides, vicinal dihalides and alpha omega dihalides. These two categories we have already seen in first year program. In geminal dihalides, which are also called as alkylidene dihalides, both the halogen atoms are present on the same carbon atom. Whereas in vicinal dihalides, which are also called as alkylene dihalides, the halogen atoms are present on adjacent carbon atoms. This is a category which is new to you. Alpha omega dihalides are also called as polymethylene dihalides. Here actually the halogen atoms are attached to the terminal carbon atoms of the chain. Now the next category is of trihalogen derivatives. When three hydrogen atoms of alkane are replaced with same or different three halogen atoms, we'll end up with trihalogen derivatives. The most common examples of trihalogen derivatives are haloforms, and this is the general molecular formula. We can get this formula by the same logic. CnH2n plus 2 is the formula for alkane, minus 3 hydrogens and add 3 halogens. So the overall formula will be CnH2n minus 1 X3. So in this category, we can take examples of chloroform, bromoform or iodoform. The next category is of tetrahalogen derivatives. In this, 4 hydrogen atoms are replaced by 4 halogen atoms. The common example is carbon tetrachloride. Or this particular compound we have come across in alkanes is also an example of tetrahalo derivative. Identify this compound. This is one IUPAC name for this one is 1122 tetrachloroethane. Now you are supposed to find out its common name and what are the uses of this compound. We have already studied about this compound in alkynes, not in alkanes. In alkynes, we have come across this particular compound. Now let's discuss about classification of aromatic halogen compounds. Benzene and its homologues react with halogen to produce addition or substitution product. Addition products are obtained when aromatic hydrocarbon is made to react with halogen in presence. Addition products are obtained when aromatic hydrocarbon is made to react with halogen in presence of sunlight. And substitution products are of two types. Substitution products are obtained in this manner. Now, aryl halides, there are two types for substitution products. First type, in which X is directly attached to the aromatic nucleus, they are called as aryl halides, haloarenes or nuclear halogen substitution products. And there are few cases in which halogen is attached to side chain, which is present on aromatic nucleus. So they are called as aryl halides. So they are basically present on the alkyl prat, which is present on the aromatic nucleus. These are the few examples of side chain halogen substitution products or aryl halides. Now let's discuss the classification of monohalogenated compounds of alkanes. Of hydrocarbons, not alkanes. Now, what is the basis for classification? The classification is based on nature of CX bond. So basically, the hybridization of carbon to which halogen is getting attached will change. Now, focus over here. So on the basis of hybridization of carbon to which halogen is getting attached, monohalogen derivatives of hydrocarbons are broadly classified into three categories. Hydrocarbons containing CsP3x bond, hydrocarbons containing CsP2x bond, and hydrocarbons containing CsPx bond. When halogen is attached to sp3 hybridized carbon, this class can be further subdivided into three more categories. The case of alkyl halides or haloalkanes, where X is attached to sp3 hybridized carbon of an alkyl group. Next category is benzylic halides, where halogen is attached to benzylic carbon, which is also sp3 hybridized. Benzylic carbon is a carbon next to phenyl ring. Third category is of allylic halides, in which halogen atom is attached to sp3 hybridized carbon, which is allylic in nature. Allylic carbon is a carbon next to carbon-carbon double bond. Further, all these alkyl halides, benzylic halides and allylic halides can be of three different types, primary, secondary and tertiary, depending upon the degree of carbon to which halogen is attached. Now sp2 hybridized carbon can be also attached to halogen. So this becomes the second category. In this second category, we can have aryl halides, in which X is directly attached to the aromatic nucleus, and if the carbon to which that halogen is attached is sp2. Or we can have alkenyl halides, which are also called as vinylic halides. And in the last category, in which sp hybridized carbon is attached to X, we can just have the cases of haloalkynes. Now let's have a revision of nomenclature. We We have already discussed the common name system as well as IUPAC system for halogen derivatives of alkanes and arenes. So these are the few common names which are listed over here. You are supposed to write down the structures of these compounds, and then based on these structures, you will be based on these common names first. You will draw the structures, and using those structures, try to assign the correct IUPAC names for the examples which are there in this list. Over here, this is not clearly visible. This last name is not clearly visible. This is nothing but tert amyl chloride. It is tert amyl chloride. I am repeating. It is tert amyl chloride. Okay. So as a homework, you will be doing this exercise using these common names. First, draw the structure, and using structure, try to assign IUPAC name.